there is nothing like entering a clean, organized, clutter-free home. Employ these tips and tricks to help declutter your home and reach that nirvana. Just imagine sitting on your couch with nothing else to do in your home but enjoy your investment. Your home is clean, organized, and clutter-free. That is an amazing feeling, and you can experience it all of the time by employing these tips and tricks to help declutter your home. 1. Develop a decluttering routine to help declutter your home. Yeah, just channel what your mother may have been telling you all of your life. Everything has a place and everything in its place. Just develop a decluttering routine. I am sure you have heard something similar before. I was the type of person to leave a trail of clothes and belonging across the house when I came home from work. Really, a trail of clothing and debris from the front door to my bedroom. It was embarrassing. Now my routine compels me to put everything where it belongs. Clothes, shoes, coat, tools, pants, and laptop all where they belong. You should develop the same kind of decluttering routine. It will only take 1 minute and relieve a whole lot of stress for you and your family. Start with the easy low-hanging fruit. You know where it is. Start today. 2. Memories should not clutter your life. Don't litter your home with small shrines. There is no need to continue the tradition of inheriting other people's items just because they once owned them or keep stuff around to remember past good times. Sure, there are items a parent, family member, or close friend may have owned that bring back good memories to mind, but that does not mean you have to own it to enjoy those memories. They are already embedded in your mind. Sometimes we keep junk because we think it may be worth money one day. If you believe the items are worth money, there is no shame in selling, donating, or giving them away to someone who can truly use them. Sometimes there is a feeling of the sunk cost that compels us to hold on to things because of perceived value. Why clutter your life with things you really do not want and things that bring no true value to your life? Get rid of it. Add the extra money to your bank account or apply the earning as a tax write-off. The great memories will still be just as sweet, and you will not spend years cleaning and moving that extra junk around the house. 3. Designate a place for incoming documents. Not as much now with the internet and modern technology streamlining our lives, but I am still amazed at how much paper invades my life. What about you? There was a time I could remember seeing something around the house I would like to get my hands on and had to go on a treasure hunt looking on tabletops, counters, drawers, and all over my car to find it. I know I just saw it, but when I needed it I could never find it. Now I put everything, mail and documents, in one place. That solved many problems for me. Most importantly, it gives me time and a place to go when I need those documents. Before, I will rush through the mail from the time it would take for me to walk through the front door to the kitchen or dining room table. Now I know where everything is. I get my dining room table back, a few drawers, and countertops too. You should give it a try. The place you choose could be a spot on a table, a drawer, a whole room, or even a shoebox. You choose what you believe will work best for you. 4. Use a, maybe, box technique to help declutter your home. One of the best ways to declutter an area is to create a discard and keep box. When you come across items, you quickly decide what box it belongs and treat it accordingly. Sometimes the decision is not that simple and a, maybe, box would be handy. Items that usually end up in the, maybe, box are things you believe will be needed one day, that day never comes, sentimental items, and items you believe have a monetary value. I say get rid of all of it, but I will allow you to decide. Store the, maybe, box out of the way for at least 30 days or 6 months. If you need any of those items, remove them from the box. After 6 months, if there are any items left, donate, give away, or sell them. 5. Clear off all counters to help declutter your home. This may seem simple, but it will go a long way to combat visual stress. There is something calming about relaxing in a freshly cleaned home with everything in its place. Clearing off your counter space can help simulate that effect. Take a look at your counter space. Does that toaster need to be there? What about those potholders, that bread maker or blender? Are there other places in the kitchen that can be stored and brought out when needed? Clear away as many items, if not all of them. Clear off all papers, books, and other junk. We are looking to achieve a clear, clean, functional, clutter, and stress-free look in the kitchen. 6. Quit overlooking the clothes you don't wear. Creating a minimalist wardrobe will simplify your morning routine, but first, let's take a look at what you actually wear. How long are you going to waste time sorting through the same clothes you do not wear every day? Some are too small, ugly, or out of season. Sell, give away, or donate clothing you no longer have a use for. Store the clothing that is out of season out of the way. Getting dressed every day should be a joy, not a stressful treasure hunt. To begin your clothing decluttering process, turn all the hangers in your closet in the wrong direction. You decide what that is. If you wear something, put it back on the hanger in the correct direction. After a period of time, it will become obvious you only wear a small portion of the clothing hanging in your closet. For me, it was just 25%. From here you know the routine: sell, donate, or give away the unnecessary clothing hanging in your closet. Your mornings will go smoother when you look in your closet and are able to put your hands or exactly what you need. Only the clothes you love to wear will be smiling at you. 7. Try this quick and simple declutter routine daily. This will require you to become ruthless about decluttering your living spaces. What is the best way to eat an elephant? Eating an elephant can only be done one way. One bite at a time. Decluttering your home can be overwhelming. Let's make it stress-free and seamless by tackling it one bite at a time. Here is what you do. Get two large boxes, storage bins, or even garbage bags. You will be using them to clear your superficial everyday clutter from your living spaces. When to come across items that you can quickly determine to be trash, put them in the box you decided would be for trash, and items you determined to be sold or donate will be put in the other box. This will be the item you have no use for or no longer bring value to your life. Like books you will no longer reference, clothing you will no longer wear, useless decorations, or anything else you would like removed from your living spaces. Just do this a few minutes a day until there is almost nothing left or you feel in control of the clutter. 8. Create a 30-day quarantine list. This is a must if you would like to avoid chasing your tail. I would declutter items just to find myself purchasing similar items again at a later date. To avoid that and other problems, I created a 30-day quarantine list. The list contains things I would like to buy, including the date I put the item on the list. These items are quarantined and cannot be purchased until the 30 days have elapsed. I have found that most of the time they desire to purchase these things usually have subsided in the 30-day quarantine. Funny how that happens. I would love to research the psychology behind that, but I will enjoy the money and time I save in the meantime. Thank you for stopping by. Click like and bang on the subscribe button. Please visit the description for even more life-changing information.